Welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790 AM. Brought to you proudly by Sportsman's Warehouse, Counts Marine, the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency, and Avery Superstore.
Hey, welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray. Wow, we had fun talking to Austin Bibb, a young, what we might say, conservationist that
loves his job.
Loves his job and spends spends time at Neiman Shelby State Park and working with hogs and all these different kind of things. But this is first Saturday, and you know that means that Gene Smith and Dave Gabbert are my co-hosts.
And what month is this?
This is June. You may not believe it, but it's going fast. The older you get, Dave Gabbert, the faster it goes.
He wouldn't know that.
Yeah, he would not know that.
He's ageless.
He's a pup. That's right. But Dave is at Sparta, Illinois, at the World Shoot up there, and is hanging on with us by phone. Of course, Gene Smith, another award winner, a Hunter Education Instructor of the Year for Tennessee, is sitting next to me, filling in that Dave Gabbert seat. And we've got a young lady on the line with us right now that we had scheduled earlier, and something happened that's a real tragic situation in the school where she teaches, and we're really glad to talk to her now. We are big Ruger people down
Amen.
Here. I mean, I've been shooting that 270 Ruger for a long time.
I got a 41 Magnum.
Oh, I can't tell you how many deer I've killed with that and wear my Ruger outfits properly. But she is the eighth addition to the Team Ruger, and that's Tina Martin out of New Bern, North Carolina. Good morning, Tina.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Great to have you on the show on Outdoors with Larry Ray. Let's talk first about being part of the Ruger team. From your standpoint, I know you've been doing this for a while. We're not going to talk age or anything like that, but you've been doing this for 16 years or so. So talk about your relationship to Ruger.
You know, and honestly, like to kind of talk about my relationship with Ruger, it really did start with my first firearm that I purchased.
Really?
16 years ago.
Okay.
Yeah, so my first gun I ever purchased was a Ruger 1022 from a local gun show. And I just, you know, I'm an outdoorsy person. I'm a biologist by my trade. And so I wanted to be out in the wild and be able to plink and have fun. And so that was my first introduction to Ruger. And then when I got into precision rifle shooting a few years ago, I was on a hunt for a really good out-of-the-box ready precision rifle.
Ooh.
And that's what Ruger provides with their RPR. So I purchased one of those and just fell in love with it. And so through other contacts I have, I started talking to the guys at Ruger, got to visit the factory, got to see some prototypes
of
some things that were coming down the line. Yeah, I'm not far from the North Carolina factory. And that just kind of developed our relationship, and then it ended up to being able to be the eighth addition to the team, which I'm extremely blessed and proud about.
Well, when your team captain is Doug Koenig, I mean, that's pretty good. I mean,
you know, exactly.
You're in with Doug. He's been on this show several times, and to be a part of this team, I know you're a busy person. I don't know how you fill in your day here. So tell our listeners where you've come from and what you do now, because you've got a really unbelievable background. You mentioned scientist. I mean, wetlands. So tell our listeners how did Tina Martin get...
Many people say I'm an onion. Like, there's tons and tons of layers.
There you go.
Yeah, I like that. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, so I started out, I went to college at Florida State University, got a degree in biology, and started out as in the ecology field. And so I was out in the field. I was a field biologist. And that kind of led for my interest in firearms anyways, because I was out a lot of places by myself or just with a small group.
Uh-huh.
And not necessarily human problems, but large animals.
Right.
And so that got me thinking about firearms in a way just to protect myself if something happened.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I my ex-husband was a military guy, and so we traveled all over the United States. And so that gave me an opportunity to try out some different fields in the scientific world. So I've done a lot of things as biologist for the state of Florida, worked in labs in Florida, North Carolina, Texas. And so I've done kind of some fun and cool things as a biologist. And then I had kids.
Three kids.
So kind of
a mother of three.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm a mother of three.
All right.
And so I've got those guys. They're 8, 10, and 12. and took time to just be part of their growing up.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
And then recently, like, life changes happen, and so I had to go back to work. And so I enjoyed, and I had started already in the firearms community about 16 years ago, like I said. And that started my venture into teaching.
Yeah.
Started with military wives.
Military and, wives, yeah.
Yep. And so often there, they would have a firearm in the home, and their husbands would deploy, and they just didn't know what to do with them.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't know how to handle them. They were scared of them. So we, you know, I kind of came in, and they're like, hey, we know you like to shoot and stuff. Could you come help me?
Oh.
And so it just kind of started helping them learn how to even just maneuver the gun to a safe place. And then it went to, hey, well, why don't you learn how to shoot this since you have it in your home? I mean, it's here. Why
yeah.
don't you learn, add that level of protection? And then it kind of just kept going from there, and I had enough people encourage me. They're like, you really should think about doing this, like, all the time. You're really good at it.
And now
this is where I am.
The owner and head instructor of Shield Maiden Defense.
So that's my company that I created a couple years ago, and it's dedicated to teaching females how to shoot. And, you know, it starts with proficiency and safety, and then if they want to go further, because, you know, some ladies just, like, take it and they really run with it. And so then, you know, next step for plinking and self-defense is to try to trial competition. So then I teach also intro to competition courses.
Wow.
Yeah, I had a lady across the street. Her husband's in the military. She thought she had a burglar, so she cocked her pistol and didn't know how to set it down. So I had to show her how
yeah.
to set it down.
Well, that's Dave Gabbert, you're in Sparta, Illinois, listening to Tina as she describes. You and I have yes. talked about this many times. The fastest growing part of the outdoor industry involves around women, and
right.
and this and shooting. We can look at the high schools, whatever it might be. Tina, you know this too. That
mm-hmm.
This is the female side of shooting is exploding is the right word or
it's
not?
It's exploding. Yeah,
yeah,
it's growing exponentially.
It really is. So talk about that.
Well, it's really interesting because I've noticed, it's funny how, and what I've noticed is with a lot of females, when just through the years, like I initially started getting, I had like younger girls who like were by themselves, so they were more worried about self-defense. Her dad encouraged them, and, you know, hey, I want you to learn how to shoot. But then I had a portion of the population that was in, say, the 50s range,
uh-huh.
and it was kind of like the next thing outside of some sort of sport. So people learn how to play golf when they're getting closer to retirement, all those things. Well, then there's this group of women who've taken on competitive shooting
yeah.
as the retirement thing to do. And so it's just, I mean, in the last 4 years, it's gotten huge with that age bracket between like 40 and 60.
40 and 60.
So these ladies are yeah. wanting, and they're like, I mean, you know, these women are manhandling large guns, like shooting shotguns like a boss.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's phenomenal, and they're excited. Their kids have already grown up and gotten out of the house. So now they want to go out and do something. And for women, I've noticed, and I know many of other female instructors have noticed, when they conquer firearms, they kind of feel like they can conquer anything.
Exactly.
I think it has to a little do with fear. But it's so empowering mm-hmm. to them as far as their abilities that overlies into all other sorts of their lives.
Mm-hmm.
And so it just makes them stronger people.
Well, Dave, can you notice that that Tina's pretty laid back and really not excited about this? I mean,
I love it.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's just not into it. I can tell right off.
No. Yeah. But you've talked about Dave. What do you say about what Tina said?
I agree with Tina's. You know, philosophy wholeheartedly, because the ladies, you know, that I have come across that I've shown and instructed, you know, once you present that firearm and explain it, it's just a tool, you know.
Yes.
It's a tool like anything else. And it would be like, cause there's a little apprehension, you know, I kind of use the analogy, hey, it's a tool. It's metal. There's wood, there's plastic, and it makes noise. So what's a sports car?
Yeah.
You know,
uh-huh. yeah.
You know, a Lamborghini or a Ferrari, hey, it's metal, it's wood, it's plastic, and it makes noise. But if I laid you know, a firearm, if they've never known anything about firearms, lay one out on the table, they're kind of afraid of it. But I pitch them keys to a brand new Ferrari out there and say, knock yourself out. You know, they done got the top down, their driving gloves on, and pushing it to the envelope.
Tina, I know you, when you hear that, and that analogy as we go with this, because I know you want the women to feel safe, confident, and effective. That's what I take
absolutely.
From your and the name itself, Shield Maiden Defense. Was that an automatic thing that came to your mind?
It kind of made me think of, I mean, if you kind of look at Viking history and stuff, like Shield Maidens, they weren't necessarily warriors by all the time. They were mothers. They were the farmers. They were the women that took care of the home.
That's right, yeah.
But when times of war needed to rise, they rose up and they became warriors too. And that's kind of how I see a lot of these ladies, is most people who see me in my daily life have no idea that I do what I do in shooting. And people are like awed when
yes.
they see it. Because I just look like that mom of three in my little grocery getter minivan, hopping back and forth to school and going to my teacher job. They realize, and they're like, well, why do you do this? Why do you? And I'm like, well, why wouldn't I? And just like your co-host said, you know, it's a tool. And for me, I want to have as many tools in my toolbox so I'm prepared for whatever situation I arises. And that's how I a lot of times teach it from that perspective. I also teach, like ladies, different types of bushcraft techniques, bug out techniques, any of those kinds of things that would help them in any situation they face.
Well,
to empower them, make them strong, protect their little ones at home.
Well, I thank you. I understand why Team Ruger's got you on that team, Tina. You should be part of that team. We appreciate you taking time. Tina Martin. Now, Tina, how can people get more information about Shield Maiden Defense and
You can go to my website, that's www.shieldmaidendefense.com, or you can find me on Instagram, and that would be Tina Martin Nims, NIMS, a.k.a. Sparky.
That Sparky is what I wanted to get in. That's that a.k.a. Tina, thank you. Have a great day, and let's stay in touch, and we'll talk later sometime, okay?
Sounds great. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you. All right, let's take a break on Outdoors with Larry Ray, and we're going to talk now about a late friend of mine that touched a lot of lives, and his legacy is going to live on through a proposed nature center. And then we're going to talk about that as we come back. First Saturday, Gene Smith and Dave Gabbard on Outdoors with Larry.
That's me.
That's you. We'll be right back.